As I said, the battle you are in now is between light and darkness, and you will begin to see great evil upon your world. Darkness is well prepared and knows when it needs to strike. This will spark a lot of fear everywhere, because the media will be a great instrument in the devil's hands to spread fear. Fear brings confusion and rash decisions, and unfortunately, the last place many will look to is to me. They will be running everywhere to gather in survival gear, food and water as a knee-jerk reaction to what will be happening. Fear will take control of the minds of men that will not be able to think straight. As evil escalates and pandemics are released, it will spread like wildfire in a forest, and many will drop dead. These pandemics are designed to kill, and they will kill faster than the previous one you had. It will be highly contagious that doctors and medical facilities will be overwhelmed, so all you have gathered in the name of preparedness will not help you. As you reel from these pandemics, natural disasters will break out. Storms, earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, hurricanes, etc. that will cut off many people from receiving help. Meanwhile, many continue to die. As you come out of one disaster, you will enter another, and as you think of escaping to another city, they will have it worse than you. These things will cut off supplies of basic important items that will become scarce, and their prices will escalate, and rationing will be implemented. Money in many households will begin to dry up as businesses suffer the effects of these disasters. As it continues, governments will start regulating movement because of the pandemics and disasters, and a lockdown will be declared, as well as martial law. The governments will now have people exactly where they need them, locked in their homes. The water will be contaminated, making it unfit for drinking, and the water you stored, if you got the chance to, will run out. Those desperate will drink the contaminated water and die. Whole families will perish in their homes. They in need with money will run to their bunkers and underground cities that are well supplied, for they have been planning this for years. Schools will be forced to close and send kids back home. Fuel will become very scarce and expensive, and many will resort to walking. Bills will become impossible to pay, as many will opt to use their money on food, and so services such as heating, gas, and electricity will be cut off. Those in winter season will suffer harsh temperatures with no heat and no power. The love of many will grow cold as everyone tries to survive. Churches and charitable organizations will only be able to do so much before they too go down for lack of resources. While people are all dazed and confused, war will hit their soil, for an invasion will take control of their nations, and many will die, and as many more are taken captive as well. They will show no mercy, as the soldiers will be under strict instructions. Indeed, pray that you shall not be a nursing mother or pregnant with child, for no one will care one bit about you. Camps will open around the world that are controlled by the governments. They will tell you to go into the camps for safety and provision, and those sick will be taken care of. Whatever name they will call these camps, or whatever they will tell you will happen there, do not, and I repeat, do not go there, for these are Antichrist camps. You will be forced to take the mark or die. Do not go anywhere near these camps. They will lure many to slaughter them. Run to the hills and the mountains. Your chances there are way better. You can form groups to survive. Consolidate what you have together and let logic kick in and accept that times have changed. You will have to have a mind shift if you will survive this dispensation. Chaos must reign for the man of sin to rise to power and offer a solution. This is their slogan, peace out of chaos, so as to form a new world order, where everything is centralized and governed by one man, the man of sin. Darkness will continue to rise, and it will look like God has abandoned your world, but not so, for it will be at the height of darkness and chaos that I will release my light, my true sons, to be the hope and salvation for many. Not only will they witness my salvation, they will protect and provide for many who will be lost and desperate. Persecution at this point will break out, as my people are sought out to be forced to join the beast or perish. Many, unfortunately, will cave into their demands so as to resume their normal lives. The sooner this world understands that there is no normal anymore, the better. Because this truth will prepare you psychologically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, every way, when you start to see these things happen. You will not be in denial. This is very important. I will protect many as long as they follow my instructions and the instructions of my chosen ones. Your survival will hinge on your obedience to my leading. Those that accept the beast system will automatically become your enemy, even if they are your family members. They will no longer be human, for they will be under the control of the devil, and you cannot be with them anymore. They will become sellouts and call the authorities on you. Their number one enemy will be the Christians. So you will have to choose to either join them or choose me and leave. If you join them, you will be eternally separated from me. Your governments and leaders are not on your side, so do not sit thinking. They have your best interests at heart. They are sold out to the beast. The beast is the one controlling your nations. So you can sit and complain all day, but nothing will change. This is the whole point, to leave you desperate, as they strip you of your rights and inflict harsh regulations on you. They will come after everything you own, wanting a piece of it, and where do you think that will leave you? Yes, desperate. They will do this to both individuals and corporates, so that many find themselves jobless, and the rest will follow. Crime will escalate in places due to this desperation, and the defense forces will not be able to keep up. Prisons will fill up. Then what? I am your only protection, hope, safety net, strength, peace, direction, your everything. And if you realize this, then you will have to come out of this system and seek me with everything. I will show mercy on whom I choose to show mercy, so this is also not guaranteed. So check your lives, how you are living your life. Do you have one foot in the world and another in me? Have you no dread that I am a jealous God? You must all make tough choices, and these choices will determine whether you live or die, and your eternal home thereafter. There is no turning back, for you have entered the final stretch. The man of sin is about to be revealed, and when he does, he will have full and total control. Is this the world you want to live in? Do not for one minute think you have time. You don't. In fact, a time is soon coming. Many will wish for death, and many will take their own lives. When the 3 days of darkness is upon you, and the destroyer comes, it's the evil in you that will attract him to you. So begin to do a thorough heart check. Repent and come out of sin, because you will not survive this event in your sin. He will torment your mind, and you will not hear me at all. Repent, I say repent, and turn away from evil. Cut off everyone who causes you to sin. If it is your hand, cut it off. If it is your eye, cut it off. live and come out of the devices of the devil. I tell you all this because I have seen the end of the matter. So what should be your posture and attitude? As Solomon concluded, this is the whole duty of man, to fear God and follow his commands, for all shall be laid bare before me, both good and evil. I am God, besides me there is no other, and I am in full and total control of everything in heaven, on earth, and beneath the earth.